But having said that, now let me bring Mayuresh Joshi, the fund manager from Angel Broking, into the conversation. Mayuresh, good morning and welcome to the show. Couple of numbers. That it has been a very busy week this week, but in particular, L&T, Hero Moto, numbers coming from cement companies. What are you liking? What are the ones, again, where you think perhaps it's looking really interesting, looking as a good sort of investment opportunity, primarily because of the earnings you have seen?
Morning, Piyush. So I think the L&T management commentary itself was testimony to the fact that the capex cycle probably looks far more robust this time around than the anticipation that we've been carrying over the last 2 to 3 years. A few of the sub-segments did disappoint. So I think power, both in terms of the revenue growth and the EBIT, did disappoint the street. But a large element in terms of how the other verticals have probably grown, and specifically the expectations from the domestic infra and E&C business, both from the order inflows that we've probably seen and the strong execution that we might witness over the next few quarters, will keep the earnings trajectory in good stead. So again, I think the guidance in terms of the order inflows, the top line growth, the Lakshya target that the management has put forth of taking margins far higher than what we are currently, to around 11.5% odd, expanding ROEs to around 17-18% odd, and doubling their top line with good execution. I think the story in terms of the long-term business dynamics remains intact for L&T. So the positive outlook for that business continues, along with the traction that it has probably witnessed on the hydrocarbon business and elevated oil prices, keeping its international books flows in good stead. For Hero MotoCorp, again, I think the input cost inflation did hit, and the gross margin, the fall that we probably saw, I think the realization downfall is something that the management was very cognizant about, and they are expected to take price hikes in the coming few months to offset all these pressures that they're probably seeing. So in terms of the margins at 15.6% that Hero MotoCorp reported, and the expected ongoing slugfest with Bajaj Auto specifically in the entry-level segment, I think Hero MotoCorp's management didn't sound too perturbed. So again, I think in terms of maintaining their market share and expectation of price hikes, should probably have realization growth remaining stable.
Mayuresh, allow me to step into, and I want to ask you that as you were just pointing out, and this question again came to me, if the numbers, again, basically the volume growth is looking solid, will you be now tempted to go out and buy Bajaj Auto, Hero Moto? There has been some good correction, more than 10-15% correction, both the stocks. And again, in terms of concerns around the price competition, where you're positioned right now? Buying right now, or you expect more dips to come and then buy, or you think perhaps it's not a place to be right now?
I think it's definitely a place to be from a long-term investor's perspective, Piyush. So what Bajaj Auto has clearly done in terms of compromising margins to gain market share and the input cost inflation for the industry as a whole has also hit Hero MotoCorp. But a large element in terms of taking price hikes and expectations of rural economy actually doing well, my own sense is that with the market share gains that Hero MotoCorp has done, or at least the stability in terms of reported numbers, volumes in double digits should be far more feasible. Realization growth should start coming back as demand, discretionary demand, genuinely starts coming back, and that should reflect positively on numbers. So you might have a short-term blip in terms of the competition intensity that you might face, but it's not across their variants. So I think entry-level variants is somewhere where you're seeing pressure, but it is getting compensated by higher variants. Bajaj Hero MotoCorp has also pointed out the plus 150cc, where I think the premiumization effect still continues and their growth probably seen. So large element of any declines onto a stock like Hero MotoCorp is somewhere where I remain extremely positive over around it.
Right, so that's the bias coming from Mayuresh again. Both Mayuresh, very quickly, as of 40 seconds to go, if I just have one vote from you on cement, Ambuja, ACC, are they good opportunities at present?
So stellar set of numbers. So I think the positive view in terms of realization-led volume growth will continue for the sector as a whole going forward. So ACC probably looks far more promising, and Ambuja's numbers were very, very stellar as well. So I think a good move can be seen on that.
Well, absolutely, again, timely answer. So that's the word coming. Deep again, looks like the numbers basically are going to open, and they're going to have L&T, SBI, Tata Motors again, all actually opening very strong.
Absolutely. In fact, the bias is with the SBI right now, Piyush. Point taken. Mayuresh, were you surprised by Canara Bank numbers, and does this sort of set the trend for some of the other PSU bank numbers that are still to come out?
Morning, Dipanchu. I think the numbers were far better than what the street was anticipating. And a lot of these managements have put forth the point that the elevated asset stress that they witnessed over the past few quarters, that element of stress should slowly start coming out, with NCLT resolutions also taking place and the expectations of the bank resolutions happening at a faster clip. I think some of the banks can do well, but I think the bias still remains in terms of the large cap PSU names at this point of time, banks like State Bank of India. Yes, the outperformance from a few mid and small PSU banks can very well get going in this quarter, but the delivery has to come on a consistent quarter-on-quarter basis. So unless you see two quarters of consistent growth, it's very difficult to put a bias in terms of their favor. So I think the large cap PSU banks is still something that will favor banks like State Bank of India.
Large cap PSU banks is still where the favor would be, but definitely a smart surprise there from Canara Bank. Let's in fact hear out a couple of comments from the management on what's led to this kind of delivery and whether this is sustainable or not. Pretty good. Mayuresh, any quick calls you want to give us? Good money making ideas for the next year, year and a half?
So I think private financials, Dipanchu, still look good. So again, stocks like an RBL Bank, Yes Bank, where the growth outlook, both in terms of the advances growth being very, very robust, reflecting clearly on the NIM momentum still remaining strong. Asset quality issues probably tapering off, reflecting in better cost income ratios and lower credit costs, and significantly improving their return ratios, specifically ROEs. So again, I think RBL Bank, Yes Bank within the private financials is something that we'll continue to like. Cement as a space is something that we've liked for a length of time. So I think the stocks have given a very good return so far. The numbers have been quite stellar by a few companies. But I think the longer term outlook still remains very, very robust, except a blip that you'll probably see because of monsoons. So Ultratech from the large cap names, ACC, JK Lakshmi Cement, JK Cement is something we'll continue to like. And the government focus on infrastructure. So I think the kind of capex that the government is doing specifically towards roads, ports, our own sense is that road contractors and stocks like KNR Construction, Sadbhav Engineering do appear to be on a very good earnings and growth trajectory.
Fair point. Thanks so much for joining in, gentlemen. Mayuresh, Jay, Dhaneshwar, Gaurav, as well as Hemen, taking us through your reading of the fresh record high that's been hit. A few points off that right now, 6 points down really, but no real concerns. Ajay Srivastava from Dimensions Consulting is also on the phone line with us.